things in theory ahead, and then we'll be coming to some of the questions in exercise one from your module. So let's start with a quick understanding of the component representation of vectors and angles in four quadrants that we had discussed last time. So what we had seen in this is that if with respect to your xy plane, we for example have a vector, the most basic example is a vector which is in the first quadrant, like the one I'm drawing over here. So if this is making an angle theta with the x-axis, we can see that its components are ax and ay, both will be positive. So we saw that the relationship is ax is a cos theta, ay is a sine theta. Magnitude of the vector a is root of ax square plus ay square, and tan theta is equal to ay by ax. Okay. So therefore we saw that in quadrant one, ax and ay are both positive, okay, and therefore tan theta is also positive. But for example, the moment we move on to quadrant 2, which is going to be some situation like this now. Now suppose we have this situation, and this is at some angle, let's say beta, okay. So for the vector b, what is happening? Bx will become negative, whereas by will become positive. Okay, and in fact, bx here will become magnitude of b into cos of that angle, so it will become minus of b cos pi minus beta. Okay, or you can say it's minus of b cos alpha. Let's say where this angle is becoming alpha, whereas by will be b sine beta, which will be positive of b sine pi minus beta, or positive of b sine alpha, like this. And therefore tan beta will be minus tan alpha. So in the second quadrant, not only do you have the justification that cos is negative and sine is positive, but you also understand the logic of these formulae by looking into this triangle. By looking into the fact that this here is your bx and this here is your by, so from the trigonometry of that triangle you understand that. And likewise in third and fourth quadrant, so we also understood that if we have some vector c in quadrant 3, that means the angle it is making, let's say gamma with the x-axis, is greater than pi but less than 3 pi by 2. This one is now looking like this. This is the vector and this is the angle gamma. Okay. Then this angle can be written as pi plus alpha, like this. Okay. And you can see that C's x component will become negative. C's y component will also become negative, because this C cos gamma will become minus C cos gamma minus pi, or minus c cos alpha, and the y component will be c sine gamma, will be minus c sine gamma minus pi, or minus c sine alpha. So sine and cos are both negative in the third quadrant. Yeah, Devashi, which part you're not getting better? Tell me, the example of third quadrant or second quadrant? Okay, so let's take some examples, we'll understand this better. Okay, so for example, if I have a vector a, let us say, such that magnitude of the vector a is 20 and थीटा इज लेट अस से 143 डिग्रीज विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू एक्स एक्सिस. सो आई वांट टू फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल ड्रॉ द वेक्टर इन द एक्स वाई प्लेन. ओके एंड शो इट्स कॉम्पोनेंट्स ज्योमेट्रिकली. ओके एंड सेकेंडली आई वॉन्ट टू कैलकुलेट ए एक्स एंड ई वाई यूजिंग द फॉर्मूले बेस्ड मेथड. ओके एंड देन आई वॉन्ट टू शो दैट cos of theta is equal to cos of or minus cos of pi minus theta. So basically you want to, you know, kind of show the logic of this trigonometric formula which you know. So you want to show these relations holding true from the vector derivation. Okay, so just take down this question and start with the first part. Just try to see how you will draw this. Okay, rest of it will become clear as I solve it for you. Just start with this, Devashri and all of you. Okay. Okay, so let's understand how the diagram looks first. So now if this is my xy plane, so in this particular case, my vector E, okay, because it is making an angle of 153 degrees with the x-axis, 143 degrees, sorry. It will be looking like this. So theta is 143 degrees and the magnitude of this vector is 20 units or whatever. So geometrically, if you want to draw the components, now what we'll have to do is we'll have to drop these perpendiculars. We'll have to drop a perpendicular onto the x-axis here. We'll have to drop a perpendicular onto the y-axis here. Okay. So just geometrically speaking, you see this will be your ax. It will be a negative quantity, you can see, and this will be your Ay, a positive quantity. You can see that ax I cap will be this vector, ay j cap will be this vector. So the vector E will be equal to some ax I cap plus ay j cap, where clearly ax will be a negative quantity and ay will be a positive quantity. Yes, Siraj, that's correct. Very good. Okay. So now the thing is, since we know theta is 143, okay, so we will know that this angle alpha will be how much? Pi minus theta, or 180 degrees minus 143 degrees, so it will be 37 degrees. So you know that this angle is 37. So if you just, and this is 20. So if you just think of this triangle here, in this triangle, what is the base? It is mod of ax. And what is the perpendicular? It is ay, because ay is positive. So ay is positive, but ax is negative. That means the base of that triangle as a length will be mod of ax, whereas the perpendicular of that triangle will be just ay. Okay, and the hypotenuse is nothing but mod of a, which is 20. So now you just apply trigonometry in that triangle, which I've shown there. So sine alpha is perpendicular upon hypotenuse. Okay, so the perpendicular is just ay and the hypotenuse is 20. So that is equal to sine 37, which is 3/5. So you can see that ay is becoming 12. Okay, but cos alpha, which is base upon hypotenuse, now that we have to be a little careful, because the base is mod of ax, because ax is a negative quantity. So that upon 20 is cos 37, which you know is 4/5. So we know that mod of ax is going to be 16, but that means ax is going to be how much? It's going to be minus 16, because we already know that ax is negative. So geometrically, we have not used any trigonometry formula and all that. We have just geometrically found out that ax is minus 16, ay is plus 12, and the vector in component form is minus 16 I cap plus 12 j cap. So this is the geometrical way of dividing the vector into its components, or resolving the vector into components. So this process is called resolution of the vector E into its components, and we've done that geometrically here. We can also do that algebraically, which we'll do in the second part. Okay. So is this clear, Devashri? See, because if these things, once they get clear, only then your exercise one problems and all will make sense, you know, without the basics. Okay, very good. Okay. So we're done with the first part of the question. We have got the vector and component from geometrically. Okay, now let's come to doing the same thing algebraically. So second part of the question, we again have the same thing we want to do. Mod A is 20 and theta is 143 degrees, but we want to find the components AX and AY by formulae. So we'll use these formulae, that AX is A cos theta and AY is A sin theta. So that is 20 cos of 143 degrees and 20 sine of 143 degrees. And then we will use the trigo formula. We'll use the trigonometry formulae for second quadrant. That is, cos of theta is minus cos 180 degrees minus theta, and sine of theta is minus sine 180 minus theta. Okay, oh, sorry, positive sign. So we'll use this. So here, cos 143 will be minus of cos 180 degrees minus 143 degrees. So that will be minus cos 37. So that is minus 4 by 5. So this becomes 20 into minus 4 by 5. So that shows you that AX again is minus 16, as we had shown geometrically. And sine 143 will be positive of sine 180 minus 143. Yes. So this becomes 20 into 3 by 5. That is why my AY is plus 12. So we've got the vector A as, but this time we've done this by formula based method. So this is resolution of vector A by formula method. Okay. And finally, if you compare notes of the two, you can understand that therefore, okay, because the vector was in the second quadrant and this angle was theta, okay, so this angle was alpha, so AX became minus A cos alpha, which is minus of A cos 180 minus theta. That gave us the formula that cos 180 minus theta, sorry, which is A cos, cos theta. And because EY was positive of A sin alpha, which is positive of A sin 180 minus theta. So this is showing us the formula that this and this formula. So this is the process of understanding the ASTC principle using vector algebra. So for each of the quadrants, quadrant 1, sine theta is positive, cos theta is positive. Quadrant 2, you have the formula, sine of theta becomes positive of sine 180 minus theta, cos of theta becomes minus cos 180 minus theta. Quadrant 3, sine of theta becomes minus sine theta minus 180, and cos of theta becomes minus cos theta minus 180. And quadrant 4, sine of theta becomes minus sine 360 minus theta, whereas cos of theta becomes positive of cos 360 minus theta. So you can see here all are positive. So obviously here tan will also be positive. Okay, so all are positive. Then here tan will become negative. So here sine is positive, okay, and here tan will become positive because it's the ratio of these two. So, and here you can see that tan is again negative, but more importantly, cos is positive. So you have the ASTC rule, but not only the ASTC rule, the formulae for finding cos, sine, tan, etc. in all the four quadrants. Yes, I have taught this in the last lecture. I'm doing a revision of this. Yes. number of people here who said they have confusion with this one. So this is a rehash of the working principle of the ASTC rule. Okay, now let's move forward in component algebra concept. Okay, now next thing we'll see is vector operations in component form. No, it's okay. You have understood the example. It's enough. There's nothing really new we have done. Now this next part is the new part. So make sure you write this down. I'll give you time to write it also. So the first operation is, as usual, multiplication by a scalar. So vector A is n times vector B, where n is a scalar. Okay. So for example, if I say that vector B is 3i cap plus 2j cap and vector A is 1.5b, okay, then this implies here that vector A will become 1.5 times. So as you can see, this also means that since vector A is 1.5 times vector B, so magnitude of A will be 1.5 times magnitude of B, okay, and the vector A is parallel to vector B. Okay, so just make a note of this quickly. When you finish writing this down, work out this next example. Okay, just work this out quickly. Okay, so we have to draw vectors P and Q in the XY frame and compare their magnitudes and directions. That's the second part of the question. Okay. We have to draw them in the XY frame and compare their magnitude and directions. Okay. So now, you can tell me what is the magnitude of P and what is the magnitude of Q. And from your diagram, you can also tell me what are their directions. Meanwhile, I'll work out the question for those who haven't done it yet. So first part, vector P is 20 I cap plus 15 J cap. And vector Q is given as minus of 0.5 into P. So we will just apply the normal multiplication kind of principle. Okay, so next step, this will become Q is equal to minus of 0.5 into 20, like a distributive principle kind of thing, plus minus of 0.5 into 15 JK. Okay, so as you can see, Q will become minus 10 I cap minus 7.5 J cap. So this is the answer to the first part. This is what you should have got for vector Q. Okay. Very good, that's correct. Now the second part, when you are drawing these vectors, you have to draw them understanding first of all that what is the magnitude and what is the direction. You can't just randomly draw them. To understand a little bit about the vectors, so about the vector P, what we can understand is this, that P is 20 I cap plus 15 J cap. So magnitude of P is 25. Okay. And vector P is at theta equal to tan inverse of 15 by 20, or that is the same thing as tan inverse of 3 by 4. So that is 37 degrees with respect to x axis. Okay. So this is what we can understand. So when we draw that vector P, it should be with that thing in mind. Okay, that doesn't have to be exact, but it has to be in mind that this angle should be 37 degrees and the magnitude of P should be labeled as 25. So this is what P vector is looking like in our XY plane. Right. Now similarly, let's come to the vector Q. When we are drawing it, we have to understand that the vector Q is minus 10 I cap minus 7.5 J cap. So its magnitude will become 12.5. No, magnitude to beta without sign hota hai na? Because remember, magnitude of a vector is square root of x component square plus y component square. So it doesn't matter that these are negative. Yes, sir. That is 100 plus ओके मतलब मच इजियर वे ऑफ डूइंग दिस इज दैट दिस इज यू कैन टेक much easier way of doing this calculation is that you can write this as 2.5 into 4 whole square plus 2.5 into 3 whole square So you can take 2.5 common. Okay. So that's how. But there's the easiest way of showing that magnitude of Q is this. Okay. Anyway. So now, what about the angle that Q is making with the x-axis? You know, we have to understand that also. So you can see that qx is negative of 10, qy is negative of 7.5. So therefore theta is tan inverse 3 by 4, but in quadrant 3, not in quadrant 1, because this is showing you that cos theta will be a negative quantity, showing you that sine theta will be a negative quantity, but tan theta is positive. Tan theta is 3 by 4 positive. So theta will become how much? It will become 180 plus 37 or 270 degrees. Okay, so now when you draw the vector v, you have to be mindful of that fact. You know? You have to draw it in such a way that your diagram now reflects this aspect that So its length will be 12.5, half of that one, but this whole angle will be 270 degrees, which means that this angle is 37, okay, which means that this angle is 180 degrees. Okay. So you can see that the vector Q is opposite to vector P. Say it is at 180 degrees or it is anti-parallel. Okay. And of course, magnitude of the vector Q is 0.5 times the magnitude of the vector P. So this all which you're understanding from geometry here is also because Q is this. If this is the relationship between them, then this has to make sense. Yeah, we have done that, na? In the first part, we have directly multiplied. Wahi to kiya hai, beta. Ye jo 10, minus 10 or minus 7.5 aaye the components, come by directly multiplying, na? But next is using this vector, we have to draw it now, na? So for example, here for P, what is happening? This component is 20 and this component is 15, but for the other one now, this component is minus 10 and this component here is minus 7.5. So hope this is clear in all respects. Okay, now next thing, very easy. Addition or subtraction of vectors by component algebra. Okay, yes. Okay, finished writing this down, Yash. Okay. That is Yash Mulchandani, of course, because we have two Yashes in the class. Okay. Addition, subtraction of vectors by component algebra. Now, this is very easy. Vector A plus B, if we express them in component form, it is just expand the vector A in its component notation. So it's AX I cap plus AY J cap plus the vector B, which is BX I cap plus BY J cap. Next, take I cap common. So you have AX plus BX I cap plus EY plus BY. Okay, so that becomes your vector. So for example, I have the vector E, which is, let's say, I cap plus 3J cap, and I have the vector B, which is 2I cap plus J cap. And I ask you, find E plus B and its magnitude. So now this is very simple. All you have to do here is for A plus B, you have to apply this formula that it is A is X component plus B is X component plus A is Y component plus B is Y component. So it is 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 1. So it is 3 I cap plus 4 j cap. This is our vector A plus B. So this is this part. Okay. And magnitude of A plus B is nothing but mod of 3i cap plus 4j cap. So it is square root of 3 square plus 4 square. So magnitude of A plus B is becoming, in this particular case, becoming 5. Okay, so this is our second part's answer. So just write this down quickly and it's very easy to understand. No, yes, lot of lectures pending before we finish this chapter. We are going to finish the first part of the chapter, which is about addition and subtraction. Okay, next, similarly, we want to calculate E minus P. as you might have guessed, that it is the difference of the x components into I cap, okay, plus the difference of the y components into j cap. Okay, so now similarly, if we have operations between multiple vectors, like we have a plus b plus c plus d, suppose, so this will become ax plus bx plus cx plus dx I cap plus ay plus by plus cy plus dy j cap. Or for example, we have this operation p plus q minus r, so this will become p's x component plus q's x component minus r's x component plus p's y component plus q's y component but minus r's y component. Okay, so this is how we can do addition subtraction of multiple combinations of vectors. So very simple, as you can see. Okay, this is clear. Okay, so let's look at an example or two now. Yes, Siraj, what happened, beta? Okay. Okay, so let's move on to an example. So now in this example, vectors are given to us in geometrical form, but we will solve them using component algebra. So let's understand. So our first vector is given to us like this. This is at this angle being 30 degrees and the vector's magnitude is 20. Then our second vector is like this. Its magnitude is also 20. Okay, so like this. And the third vector let's say like this. Okay. And this angle is 30 degrees and its magnitude is also 20. So now the question itself is, first part, express vectors A, B and C in component form. Okay, then second part, find A plus B and the magnitude of A plus B. Third part, find A minus B and its magnitude. And third part, find A plus B minus C and A plus B plus C. So just work this out quickly, people. With this, you will learn the applications of all the things we've been discussing today. Remember, in the case of C, the arrow is pointing like this. This is the arrow of C, how it is pointing. Whereas in the case of E, the arrow is pointing in this direction. So you people have to give me the answers in terms of A, B, and C. Okay, which is the vector A you have said, which is the vector B. So yeah, most of you got vector A correct. So when you are sending the answer, at least you know label them as the vectors A, B, C, no? Okay. Yeah, it's okay. So anyway, let me put up the answers for the first part. So the first part, the vector A should come out to be 10 I cap plus 10 root 3 J cap. The vector B should come out to be minus 20 I cap. So this direction is along the negative axis. And vector C will come out to be minus 10 I cap plus 10 root 3 J cap. So please make sure you're getting these. Okay? If you're getting confused about B and C, just draw them separately from the origin. No? Yes, Bhavesh, your answers are correct for first and second. Raj, I think your sign was just check on the sign once. Yeah, it's clear now, no? Okay. So about C, about the other two vectors, no? B and C, you have to understand that if you draw B and C from the origin of your system, then B is not in the first quadrant. Okay, B is actually like this. B is, so it's pointing along the negative x direction. It's at angle 180 to the x axis. And similarly, if you draw the vector C here, you'll see that it's like this. Vector C is such that this angle is actually 120 degrees because it's along this line. So that's how you'll get this in this. So, you know, as far as the vector A is concerned, the magnitude of vector A is 20 and theta is 60 degrees with respect to x-axis. Because this angle is 60. But similarly, as far as vector C is concerned, the magnitude of C is 20, but theta is not minus 60 or something. Theta is this one, yeah. So it's 120 degrees with respect to x-axis, that you can see in this diagram. Second diagram, you can see its direction. Okay, so now work out, once you've got the vectors in component form, it's very easy to work out the sum, difference and all these combinations.
side.
यस सो ए प्लस बी विल बी 20 इन मैग्नेट. नहीं नहीं अरे क्या किया यार, इट्स नॉट करेक्ट बेटा. ओके लेट्स सी. सो सेकेंड पार्ट ए प्लस बी, जस्ट सब्स्टिट्यूट ए ना. सो ए वॉज 10 आई कैप प्लस 10 रूट 3 जे कैप एंड बी वॉज माइनस 10, सॉरी बी वॉज माइनस 20 आई कैप. ओके सो ए प्लस बी इज माइनस 10 आई कैप प्लस 10 रूट 3 जे कैप, बिकॉज नेक्स्ट स्टेप व्हेन यू ओपन दिस दिस विल बिकम 10 माइनस 20 आई कैप प्लस 10 रूट 3 जे कैप. ओके सो दिस इज योर ए प्लस बी. ओके सो इनफैक्ट यू कैन सी दैट E plus B happens to be C. But anyway, that's a different matter. Okay. And therefore, magnitude of A plus B will be square root of 10 square plus 10 root 3 square. That is 20. Okay. So few of you got this correct. Okay. Siraj, your answer is correct. Answer is correct for A minus B also. So next we have to find A minus B and is minus of minus 20 j. So this time it will become 10 plus 20. So 30 I cap plus 10 root 3 j cap. So 30 I cap plus 10 root 3 j cap. This is our E minus B. Okay. And therefore magnitude of E minus B square root of 900 plus 300, so 1200 okay. So that is 20 root 3 yeah. Okay so that's that. Then A plus B plus C just become 10 minus 10 or 10 minus 20 minus 10 I cap okay plus 10 root 3 plus 0 plus 10 root 3 j cap, so that is becoming minus 20 I cap plus 20 root 3 j cap. So notice again that A plus B plus C is actually two C. That's just happening as a coincidence, you know, because this was the case, you noticed this earlier. So you can see from that this much, this twice of same. So anyway, and you will get similarly a plus b minus c zero ho jayega, hai na? So that will be a is x component, which is 10, plus b is x component, which is this, and c is x component, which is this. Plus a is x component plus b is component minus c is x component. Okay, so you can see that is 0 I cap plus 0 j cap, which is nothing but the null vector. This is also pretty obvious because a plus b was c. Okay, so therefore a plus b minus c will have to be c. Yeah, this one will have a magnitude of 20√3. This one will have a magnitude of 40. This one will have a magnitude of 0. Okay, so as you can see that doing vector operations like addition, subtraction, etc., it becomes very easy in component method. Okay, so let's turn our attention now to exercise one of your module. We'll do some specific questions, okay, including some questions which I have received from you as doubts. Yeah, I'd ask you to attempt some questions from exercise 1 up to about 22. No, Sneha, this is not the last topic. We have lots of things more to do in vectors. You know, we have to next move on to three-dimensional components of vectors. That is why only exercise 1 up to question 22 is in your scope. Okay, we have to do three-dimensional vectors. Then we have to do this thing, you know, other operations like scalar product and cross product, etc. Okay, let's come to module exercise 1. Question 1, all of you go through the question, I'll explain it. Right, so gone through the question. So it's saying that sum of the magnitudes of two forces acting is 16 newtons. So let's say we have two forces given by the vectors A and B. So it says sum of their magnitudes, that means mod A plus mod B is 16. Or in simple terms, we can just say that this is 16. Okay. Whereas it also says that resultant is normal to the smaller of the two forces. Okay, so let us say A is equal to x, suppose. So B is 16 minus x. Okay, and let us say x is smaller than 16 minus x. Okay. Then what is happening? The resultant of A and B, that means the sum of A and B, this resultant is perpendicular to. This is such that this resultant is perpendicular to A. Why? Because A is the smaller of the two. So in a vector diagram, it will look like this. This is your vector A, suppose. This is your vector B. Oh, sorry. This is not your vector B. The resultant is the one which is perpendicular. So your vector B will be something like this, so that the resultant is perpendicular. So this is 16 minus x in magnitude. This is x in magnitude. This is the angle theta between them. But now the important thing here is ki yahan pe jo unka resultant hai, wo kaisa hai, wo a ke perpendicular hai. So it's like this. And what else is given to us? That resultant has magnitude of 8. So it's of magnitude 8. Okay. Now it's very simple. You have to just solve this triangle. It's a right angle triangle. So 8 square plus x square is 16 minus x whole square. That's it. X is equal to 6, 16 minus x is equal to 10. So magnitude of the vector A is 6, magnitude of the vector B is 16, and magnitude of A plus B is 8. So B is 10, not 16. And so you can see they are naturally a Pythagorean triplet. Okay. 8 square is 10 square minus 6 square, all like that. And so pretty straightforward question actually. To just use the geometry of triangle. Okay. Now I want you to try out question number 2 and 3 yourself. Work out question 2 and question 3. Question 2 is just logical. Okay, so just work it out in your mind or work it out in your notebook and check it against the answer which is given. I will explain each of it carefully, but first I want you to go through the options of question 2 very carefully and consider yourself and mark which options you think are correct. Compare it with the answer given at the back. Then I'll explain it in detail and then come to question 3. Question 3, make a diagram and try to understand it from the diagram. Okay, so hope you understood the very good. Good, Yash. So second question, it says the component of a vector is always less than magnitude, greater than magnitude, or equal to magnitude, or none of these. So it's very easy to understand that question two, if we have a vector A, for example, which is of magnitude A and angle theta, then its x component is A cos theta. So cos theta can be 1 if theta is 0. Cos theta can be less than 1 if theta is greater than 0. Cos theta can even be 0 if theta is 90. Okay, so all these possibilities is there, no? But cos theta is not greater than 1. It cannot be greater than 1. Okay. So therefore, you can see that in general, Ax is less than equal to A. Same for Ay also. If you think about the other component, Ay, it is A sine theta. So sine theta is less than equal to 1, but cannot be greater than 1. So Ay is less than equal to A, depending on what the angle is. Okay, so accordingly, it's not necessarily always less in magnitude. It can never be greater. Okay. It's not always equal to the magnitude also. So it's none of these. Okay. The correct answer would have been it may be less than or may be equal to. Okay, so the correct answer would have been that AX or AY may be equal to or may be less than the magnitude of the vector. This would have been the correct answer. So that's not there. So it's none of these. कंपोनेंट वही है ना बेटा, ए एक्स एंड ए वाई आर द कंपोनेंट्स. डेफिनेशंस पढ़ाने, ए एक्स इज कॉल्ड द एक्स कंपोनेंट, ए वाई इज कॉल्ड द वाई कंपोनेंट, एंड कलेक्टिवली दे आर कॉल्ड द कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ द वेक्टर. दैट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ द टर्म कंपोनेंट दैट वी लर्नड इन द थर्ड और फोर्थ लेक्चर आई थिंक, व्हेन वी इंट्रोड्यूस कंपोनेंट अलजेब्रा. ओके, लेट्स कम टू क्वेश्चन थ्री. So it says that we have a vector which is at an angle of 30 degrees with the y-axis and has an x component of 10. The magnitude of the vector is how much? Okay. This geometrically. Okay, so if this is our xy plane, then our particular vector now at an angle of 30 degrees with the x-axis, sorry, with the y-axis. So ये भी हो सकता है. One possibility is that it is this vector. That this angle is 30 degrees and this is the vector. Or there could also be one more possibility, ना? Could also be this vector. Now if you include the negative y-axis, then it could be opposite of these also. Okay, it could also be this vector, let's say. So our second vector could also be this vector, which this angle. That this is plus 10. Okay, so Ay is how much we don't know. Okay, but now we know that this angle is 30 means this angle is 60. So Ay by Ax is tan 60. So Ay is root 3. So the vector A is 10 I cap plus 10 root 3 j cap. So that means its magnitude is 20. That is. So if the geometry of component algebra is clear to you, no, it's very easy to solve these type of questions. So here you just forget about this one. It can't be this vector. Okay, now we'll discuss one interesting question. Next, question number 6. Okay, just try this out. Fourth and fifth you will be able to do. Try it out yourself later, you'll be able to do. Question 6 is interesting. First, I want you to draw the diagram or draw the vectors. In the xy plane. Okay, the first thing I want you to do is try this, then we'll discuss further. That's also fine, no? Yes. A cos theta is 10 and theta is 60 degrees, so you can do it that way also. So you can see that. So there is more than one method, that's correct. You can do like this, that Ax is given as 10. So this means that magnitude of A into cos theta is 10 and theta is 60 degrees, you can see, because the angle with the x-axis is 30. Okay. So A cos 60 is 10. That means A by 2 is 10. So A is 20. So now you can also see that Ay will be A sine theta. So that will automatically make it 10 root 3. So you know the components, you know the magnitude, everything is known. Question 4 you can do better. Devashi, you can try it out again based on what we've learned today. We've done a lot of questions of practice of that type today in class. I think you had the problem with the angles in the four quadrants. Now that that is clear today, you'll be able to solve it. Okay, so hope you've understood how to draw the three vectors. See, it's saying that the vectors lie along. So let's say I'm labeling the three vectors as A, B, and C. So the question says that the vectors are along the sides of an equilateral triangle, okay, taken in order. Okay. So basically, let's try to understand what this statement means, that the sides taken in order. Okay, let's say this triangle is some triangle PQR. Okay, so that's your equilateral triangle. So the vector A is along side PQ, then B is along side QR, and C is along side RS. This is the meaning of this statement. Okay, so this statement here, it means this. So that's the first thing you have to understand in this question. Okay, so suppose this is your equilateral triangle PQR. So you can see that properties of equilateral triangle, these angles are all 60 and the lengths are same of all three sides. Okay, so now vector A has a magnitude of 1 unit, B has a magnitude of 2 units, and C has a magnitude of 3 units. But their directions are like this. Okay, so now in this diagram, if you superimpose the vectors, so A will become a vector which is along PQ, so it's in this direction, but its magnitude is just 1, so it's like this. So its magnitude is just 1, but in comparison, for example, B will be a vector of magnitude 2, but along this side. So it's like this. So B is a vector like this, but its magnitude is double of this one. So it's maybe even longer. Maybe B is something like this. Okay. And then C. Is along the third side, along QR, but its magnitude is 3 units, so it's even longer. C is something like this. So this is your vector C, and this is 3 units. Okay, so you have to be understanding of this fact over here, very important in this question. So this angle is 120. This angle is 120. So now from this figure, next what I want you to do is redraw vectors A, B, and C in the XY plane. Okay, from the origin, draw them from the common origin and then express them in component form. So do this first, then we'll come closer to solving the problem. Once you express them in component form, you know how to add them. That's very simple. So, what I want is you should be able to do this step properly now next. This one. So after redrawing them with a common origin, or from the common origin, you can say, you should also be able to write them in component form correctly. So if you just pick up these vectors A, B, and C from there, they'll be like this. This vector A is of 1 unit here. Vector B will be of 2 units, but at 120 degrees to it. And vector C will be of 3 units, but at 120 to this. So vectors will be looking like this. Okay. This angle will be 120 degrees. This magnitude will be 2, and this is vector B. And this angle will again be 120 degrees. This magnitude will be 3, and this is vector C. Okay. So just compare to the two diagrams and make sure you understand how we have, you know, how we have drawn the same vectors but in different thing now. Like this. Yeah, we've just redrawn them from the origin. So same three vectors, we just picked them up and drawn them here and here. Okay. So now, having done that, what is my vector A in component form? It should just be I cap. What should be my vector B in component form? It should be minus I cap plus root 3 j cap. And what should be my vector C? It should be minus 3 by 2 I cap minus 3 root 3 by 2 j cap. Because for this, you just use the relation that cos 120 is minus cos 60, that is minus half, and sine 120 is sine 60, which is root 3 by 2. And for C, use the relation that cos of 240 is minus cos 60, so that's again minus half. But sine of 240 is this time minus sine 60, is minus root 3 by 2. Okay. So C's x component is 3 cos 240. C's y component is 3 sine 240. Okay, so that's how we are getting this. Similarly, B's x component is 2 cos 120. B's y component is 2 sine 120. So that's how we are getting this. So just make sure you understand these. So this is where your component algebra and components and all this trigonometry in four quadrants, these all concepts become very important. So now the resultant of A plus B plus C, which you want to find out, It's just the sum of these. So it is 1 minus 1 minus 3 by 2 I cap plus 0 plus root 3 minus 3 root 3 by 2 j cap. So you'll see that this resultant is minus 3 by 2 I cap minus root 3 by 2 j cap. So its magnitude is what you have to find out. It will just become this. That's it. Its magnitude is root 3. So that's your final answer. Okay, so hope all of you understood the process here. So the first thing we did is we redrew these vectors with respect to xy axis so that we can break them in component form. Okay, and then we use component algebra to add them. Okay, now there's also one more way to do it, and I'll give you a quick discussion of that before we complete the session today. Now we can also do the calculation of this resultant a plus b plus c. We can also come up with a geometrical solution. So like we've done in triangle law, but only this time we have more than two vectors to add. So we'll have to add them this way, that this is your vector E, okay, which is of magnitude 1. Are component form beta formula use kiya na? See Bhavesh, the vector B is of magnitude 2. And it is at angle 120 degrees with the x-axis. So I'm just using formula. Bx is b cos theta. So 2 cos 120. So that is minus 1. That is what I explained in so much detail over here also. You know? Explain to you these how we got bx, by, cx, cy. Understood, Bhavesh? Okay, good. So now see, the other way of solving this question is what I'm showing you below here. So suppose now I want to add them geometrically. So vector A was in this direction and was of magnitude 1. Okay, so that was our vector A. Its magnitude is 1. In comparison to that, where was vector B? Vector B was at 120 degrees to it, and its angle was, and its magnitude was 2. So after completing the displacement A, you are going in this direction. That is your vector B. And the magnitude of B is 2. And this angle is 120 degrees. And then your third vector C was at an angle of 120 with respect to B. So B ke direction se mujhe aisa 120 turn karke C ke direction mein jana hai, which is of magnitude 3 units. So C is like this. So ultimately, if I place them head to tail to do the addition, it's like this. Okay, so in the geometrical solution, what we do is we draw A, B, and C in succession. Okay, that is head to tail. Okay, so now after completing A plus B plus C, this is our final position. And where did we start from? We started from here. So our resultant of the three is now going to be this vector. The resultant of the three is going to be this. So this one's magnitude we want to find out how much it is. Okay. Now that's very easy to see, because in the diagram you can see there is a hidden equilateral triangle. How there's a hidden equilateral triangle is like this. See, this angle is 60. This angle is 60. So if I just extend this line, this angle will also become 60. Okay. So that means if this side is 2, this side is also 2, and this whole side is also 2. Okay. So that means now, see, within this, this will become 1. Because this side was 2 and the whole thing is 3. And this will also be 1. The whole side is 2 and this side was 1. So now you can see that this is an isosceles triangle. So this is very easy to solve. So if you separately see that triangle, this is of magnitude 1. Then we have this side, which is also of magnitude 1. And then finally you have this side, whose magnitude we are trying to calculate. Ye kitna hai nikalna hai. But we also know one more thing, that this angle here is 60. So this side is equal to this side. So this angle will be equal to this angle. So alpha will be 30 degrees, because 2 alpha is 60, the exterior angle. So that's one thing easy. And then you drop this perpendicular here. So you make use of that isosceles triangle concept. So this will also bisect. So this is x, this is x. So you can see that x by 1 is cos 30. So x is root 3 by 2. So therefore my magnitude of r is 2x. So the magnitude of the resultant is root 3. So mod of a plus b plus c is root 3, because that is what the vector r is. R is the sum of the three vectors. Okay. So this is like a more creative kind of solution, but it is subject to the thing that it should strike you that when you draw this diagram, you can break this quadrilateral into equilateral triangle plus an isosceles triangle and solve it easily. So this is the second method of solving it. Okay. But the thing is, the component method will always work. Whether this strikes you or not, will always work. Okay. So that's it for today's session, people. I will be sending you a separate worksheet also, but also attempt question number 1 to 22, everything of the exercise 1. Okay. So homework, I'll be sending you a worksheet. That'll be worksheet number 4 for you in vectors, plus exercise 1 up to question 22 from the module. Okay. So this is for the next time. Okay. And make sure you revise everything you've done in today's lecture, because very important things about component algebra we've learned. Okay. So that's it, people. Thanks for attending. Yes, I will send the notes and the video, everything. Don't worry.